After playing Mario 35 for an hour or something like that, I quickly realized that it's just Mario 1. That's all it is. And while there are many more enemies, chances are that you could probably add more enemies to the original game and get a similar experience without a limited time to play the game. Or the hard requirement for an internet connection. It is a good game. The physics are good. And just like the original game, the music is good. However, the menu music is not good. It's all right, but very forgettable. The controls are fine. Except when you play on handheld, that's very uncomfortable. And the button placement is not great. One could argue that playing with X and A would be a better control scheme than Y and B or B and A. You should try it if you're playing for Nintendo's online service. I hope they make more of it. I hope we get a Mario 3 version of it at some point. And I hope that Nintendo's not just gonna pull the plug on that thing and keep it as a vague memory. Because it would be a shame. I will have to give this game a 4 out of 10. Because it is truly uninspired. And it doesn't try to push any boundaries. It is very below average. And the only reason why I give it a 4 and not lower is because for the little that it has to deliver, at the very least, it delivers it perfectly. It is a perfectly unoriginal game. It doesn't feel like anything new. And it doesn't feel old. It just feels like Mario 1, but with more enemies and a single life.